Hello friends, in this session we are going to discuss about creating and managing snapshot standby database. First, what is snapshot standby database? So snapshot standby database is a fully updatable standby database created by converting physical standby database. So if you want to create the snapshot standby database, what do you require? You require the first the physical standby database. Once you have physical standby database, after that you can just convert this physical standby database to the snapshot standby database, and it is a fully updatable. That means you can perform the insert, update, delete, whatever the activity you want to do, like creating table, inserting data. So that is basically used for the testing purpose. Fully updatable, anything whatever you want to do, you can just do it with this database. Snapshot standby database receive an archive but do not apply redo data from primary database. So at this moment you are converting physical standby database to snapshot standby database, fine. So what happened to the primary? Primary is sending the redo information to the your standby, but at this moment your standby database is in the snapshot, so that's why it's receiving the redo but is not applying the redo to the snapshot standby database. When the physical standby database is converted, an implicit guaranteed restore point is created and the flashback database is enabled. So whenever you are converting physical standby to snapshot standby, on that time what happened? It is implicitly created one restored point and also the flashback is enabled. So let's see the architecture. See here, this is the primary database transaction. It's going on as usual, insert, update, delete, whatever the activity you are doing, log writer, LSN, everything is fine. Here the RFS is also fine. It is writing the redo data to the standby redo log files and generating the archive redo log files, fine. But here in the snapshot standby database, MRB process is not there. Why? Because it is receiving the redo information but it is not applying to the your snapshot standby database, because here we are performing some activity. Next, so when activating the snapshot standby database, you need to aware of potential data loss with the corrupted log file. So in case whenever you are using the snapshot standby database and on that time if the redo log files are corrupted, so you will find the data loss. Lengthy conversion of snapshot standby database to the primary database is an event of the failure of the primary database. So these things also need to remember. If the lengthy snapshot database, we are working on the lengthy process you are doing on the snapshot standby database, on that time if primary is failure, on that time you will also find some data loss. Next, snapshot standby database cannot be the only standby database in the maximum protection configuration. So what happened? If you are primary and the standby database are in the maximum protection, it should not be there if you are using the snapshot standby database, because if you are converting your physical standby to snapshot standby, on that time your redo is not applying. So what happened? The primary will be shut down. So whenever you are converting physical to snapshot, your database should not be in the maximum protection configuration data guard. Next is a target of switchover. So whenever you are performing switchover, so on that time this should not be happen, the switchover, because your database in the snapshot. So you first you require to convert your standbys to physical, then you can perform the switchover. So on that time whenever you are doing the activity, don't perform the switchover or your another standby database which require for the switchover. And the fast start failover target, so if you have enabled the fast start failover and if you are using the snapshot standby database for the same database, it is not going to be performed because this is in the snapshot standby. So let's see how to create and how to configure, how to manage the snapshot standby database practically. So let's see practically converting the physical standby database to snapshot standby database. So first of all, on the standby database server, what you need to do, you need to just check the status. So select status from v$instance. So here I'm just connecting to the standby database. So this is my primary. So I'm just minimizing it and I'm just checking physical standby database. So I'm just connecting to the SQL plus sysdba. Fine. So this is the standby. Select status from v$instance. This is the mounted. So at this moment, your database is in the mount mode. Next, what you need to do, you need to just check database role. So select database role
this is the physical standby. Fine. Next, you need to just check on primary. Select status, instance name, database role, open mode from v$database and v$instance. So this thing you need to execute on your primary machine. So let me connect to the SQL plus. This is the open mode, primary, database role is also primary, and it is a read write mode. Fine. So before converting the physical standby database to the snapshot standby database, all these things you need to just check. Select thread maximum sequence from v$archive group by thread. So the thread is 1, maximum sequence is 12. Also just check the flashback is on or not on your primary. So first just check on the database, we select flashback on from v$database. So this is no, it's not enabled. So from 11gr2, enabling and disabling the flashback can be done when the database is open. So directly your database is open, directly you can just enable the flashback. So I'm just executing the command, very simple command, alter database flashback on, which is going to be enabling the flashback. So database is altered. Fine. On standby, just check status, instance name, database role, open mode from v$database. So here I'm just checking on the standby, mounted primary, physical standby, and is a mounted mode. Fine. So once you do this thing, next, just check the thread max sequence from v$archive log group by thread. So this is, you need to just check. So before that, what I am doing, just doing the switch lock. Now come to this, just executing this command on the standby, because on the primary I have just performed the switch lock. 15. Fine. So here the also the sequence number you can just check, this 15. Fine. So everything is synchronization is going on from primary to standby, everything is working fine. Also check whether the flashback is on or not on standby. This thing you need to verify, because on the primary we have enabled, but no, on the standby it is not enabled. Fine. So here what you need to do, you need to just first cancel the recovery. So at this moment on the standby, recovery is going on physical standby database, recovery is going on. So that you need to just first of all cancel. So I am just canceling this recovery on standby. So this is the data at this moment, recovery is canceled. So no transactions are going to be applied on the standby. So here flashback is, you need to enable the flashback on standby. So flashback is enabled now. And what you need to do now, shut down immediate, startup mount, and convert the database to the snapshot standby. So here, shut down immediate. Startup mount. And after that, just convert this database to the your snapshot standby. Fine. So I'm just copying this, alter database convert to snapshot standby. So this is going to be convert your database to the snapshot. Fine. So you can just check database is alter. So your database is now converted to the snapshot standby database. Here you can just check the status again. This is the very important. Here you will not find physical database. Here you will find the snapshot standby database. This is mounted mode, snapshot standby, instance name is primary, that is fine, and the status is mounted. But this is changed from physical standby to snapshot standby. Fine. So this everything we have done on the your standby database. After that, what you can do, you can just open the database, alter database open. This everything you need to do on the standby, because we are converting physical standby to snapshot standby. So I'm just opening the standby database that is now as a snapshot standby database. So this is open now. Select status, instance name, database role, open mode from v.database. You can just check this thing again. This is a snapshot standby and it's a read write mode. Next, create some table and transactions as the test on snapshot standby. Fine, so you need to create, once you converted this physical standby to snapshot standby, what you need to do, just create few tables on snapshot standby database, generate some archive logs on primary, and also check if they are not being applied on standby. So here what I'm doing, I'm just creating the few of the tables on snapshot standby database. So here, let me just connect to the Scott and Tiger. Find create table snap test ID number name varchar 200. So table is created because this database is in the read write mode and this is the snapshot standby database. So here I am just inserting the few records. So ID 1 and the snap test column name is test. This is fine. Okay. Once you do this thing, next generate some archive logs on primary. Switch log file and the same thing you need to just check over here whether it is applying or not. So connect SHTBA ORCL and using this command you need to just check whether this archiving are applying or not on your snapshot standby database. It should not be applied. So here I am just executing this command on standby. So sequence is 21. Here sequence is also 21. But here whether this is applied or not, that you need to check. So for that we have a command. That command you need to execute. So here you can, using this command, you can just check whether this last received and last applied. So here this command you need to execute on snapshot. See here, last sequence is received 1, last sequence is applied is 1. Why? Because this is the snapshot database. This is the snapshot standby database. So here the archive logs are starting with the 1. But the same thing if you are checking on your primary, here the last is 21, here applied is not going to burn because this is the primary. So this is the last received is, last archive log is, that is the max sequence is 21. But if you are checking the same thing over here, last received is 1, last sequence applied is 1. Because so here at this moment snapshot standby database is not receiving, is not applying any kind of archiving data. Redo data is not applying to the your snapshot standby database because based on the archive logs. Okay, we can just check the sequences over here. Next, what you need to do here, once you do this changes, okay, and once you just check the whether the applying is done or not, so it is not applying. Now just check the restore point. So if you want to just check the restore point, you can also check because we have enabled the flashback. So here v dollar restore point. Fine, so here you can just check because from based on the restore point it is going to your do the flashback. So here one restore point you have, fine, that is the SCN is 789900, database incarnation 2, guaranteed yes. Fine, so this is the your one restore point is there. Fine, now once you converted your physical to snapshot, you have created some table in it. We have also checked whether the primary data is applying to the standby or not, so it is not applying. You also check we have enabled the flashback, and you also check the restore point is there. Fine. What you can do the next is viewing the snapshot standby database information. So here just check the database role. So we already checked this thing. So this is the for the confirmation, just check it. This should be your snapshot standby at this moment. Fine, this is a snapshot, that is fine. Now the next task what we require, once you do the your testing and everything is done, fine, you need to convert your snapshot standby database to the physical standby database. Once your testing task is done, next what you can do, convert this snapshot standby to physical standby. So here what you need to do, you need to just shut down the your database, convert the snapshot standby database back to the physical standby database. So what you need to do, shut down immediate, fine, start up mount mode. Fine. Next, you need to convert to the this physical standby database. Fine. So here, just convert it, Ultra database, convert to physical standby. Fine. So this is going to be converted to the physical standby. Very simple steps. Again, shut down immediate, start up to mount mode, and just start the recovery. So this is going to be converted to the your physical standby. So whatever the tables you have created during the snapshot standby, that is going to be removed. Fine, because whatever the transactions you are doing, that is going to be discarded once you convert snapshot to physical standby. So here just start the recovery, that is a real time apply we are doing because we have a already the standby ready log files. And here again you can just check the scripts. So I'm just using this script, which is the last is applied, last received, 21, last applied 21. So this is fine. Before that, in the snapshot standby you can just check, that is the 11, fine, but here you can just check there is a 21 21. And also I'm just performing few log switching. Fine, and here you can also check. So this, it will take some time because here we have some background process needs to be started. So it is, let me just, is the 26th, but here it will take some time. So let me just check all the background process is started or not, because sometimes it will take some time once it is converted to the physical standby. It will take some time to convert this starting this background processes. So here archiving process is not started, applying is going on, so RFS process is not started. So I need to just check whether the LNS is started or not here. So LNS is started, but RFS is not started at this moment, so this will take some time. So wait for a few minutes, after that it is going to be started automatically. Fine. So here this is the steps for converting the your physical standby to snapshot standby and snapshot standby to your physical standby. Fine. Here also you can just check the your restore points. So here you can just check whether the restore points are available or not. It is not available. Why? Because in the snapshot standby you enable the flashback, and whenever you are converting snapshot to physical, it is going to roll back whatever the transaction is done between your during your snapshot standby, and it will just restore your database based on the your restore point. When once you are enabling the flashback and once you converting physical to standby, snapshot standby, on the time it is create one restore point, and whenever you are doing the reverse process, snapshot standby to physical, on the time it will just restore up to that point. Fine. So in this way you can just perform convert your physical standby database to snapshot and snapshot to physical. Thank you.